Here we presents the top 5 best gaming keyboards. Starting at number 5, Razer Black Widow. This is a full-size keyboard with 110 keys, inclusive of the number keys. When you consider the size, it feels pretty compact and not too large, even with all those keys. It also looks rather dense, but I attribute that to the color, matte black. The dense look isn't necessarily a bad thing, since gaming keyboards have a tendency to take up space. I like the fact that the Black Widow is more considerate of my desktop real estate. That said, there are some design quirks that make this keyboard a characteristic Razer product. It has case slopes on the bottom to give your wrists room. There is a lit logo right in the middle of the slopes. The rear feet also have two sizes, so you can choose which slope you want. On the bottom there is cable management built into the keyboard, so you can hide away the braided cable. All this makes for a clean look. Now, I didn't like the fact that there aren't any dedicated macro keys, and I felt that was a big thing to miss in a keyboard this pricey. However, on the plus side, the Synapse software does allow you to customize nearly all the keys. It also has Hypershift, which allows you to customize secondary hotkeys. It also lets you create profiles and store them on the keyboard for any number of games you play. This includes key mapping as well as lighting schemes. You can store a maximum of 5 profiles on the gaming keyboard and more on the PC's memory. If you would like to be able to customize the lighting on the keyboard, you can use Chroma Studio on the Synapse, which lets you customize the RGB lighting on every key. This includes timing, color, and even patterns. For more information and price, check out the product links in description. At number 4, Kinesis Freestyle Edge RGB. This keyboard is the successor to the Kinesis Freestyle Edge. It has some improvements, such as the addition of 16.8 million colors. The most interesting thing about it, however, is that it is a split keyboard. Split keyboards are like standard keyboards, except they're split in half. The right side has lots of navigation keys arranged slightly differently than you might be used to in a normal keyboard. Everything else is as it should be. There are two separate function keys, one on either side. The programmable key on the left side is more general purpose and allows you to program macros and remappings. It also has control over the F1 through F6 keys, which can be used as media keys. The function key on the right side activates F7 through F12, allowing you to do some unique things, such as NK rollover, virtual drive, and so on. There's also a set of programming keys that allow you to remap keys, edit macros, and change profiles. These are at the top of the right half. When the two halves are together, they should be about 15.5 inches wide, just like a normal keyboard. The appeal is that you can have the two halves placed however you like them. There is also a braided cable between them with an allowance of 12 inches of separation. However, if you need more separation, 8 more inches can be found at the bottom of the keyboard. Halfway of my listed number 3, Corsair K63 Wireless. The Corsair K63 Wireless is based off of its identical wired predecessor, so the design is pretty much the same as well. In fact, if you've seen other Corsair keyboards, then the design on this one shouldn't surprise you. The keycaps float gracefully atop a powerful blue backlight. I like this feature, and I love the fact that Corsair kept it in their wireless keyboard. Many manufacturers will not maintain the backlighting system in their wireless keyboards. The usual excuse is that it drains battery power. I think they're just being mean most of the time. Speaking of couch gaming, this keyboard represents couch gaming at its best. I remember loving the Corsair Lapdog when it came out, as it brought PC gaming to the couch. The K63 Wireless is pretty much the wireless version of the concept. The greatest change in the K63 Lapboard is that it's smaller than its predecessor, and only supports 10 keyless keyboards. You also don't get an internal USB hub as everything is expected to be wireless. All things considered, I think the Lapboard is just a plastic holder for peripherals with a comfortable underside. That doesn't justify the price point. At the very least, they could have added a USB hub and an internal battery to justify the Lapboard's price. The battery life of this wireless keyboard is 75 hours at the maximum, so long as you don't leave the backlight on. If you let the backlight stay on, even at a third of its brightness, you can expect it to run for only 25 hours. Have the backlight at full light, and that reduces to 10 hours. For more information and price, check out the product links in description. Coming in at number 2. Logitech G513. The Logitech G513 is the successor of the Logitech G413, and so there aren't many major design changes over its predecessor. The keyboard is just as compact, and the frame is still made of rigid plastic with a top plate of aircraft grade 5052 aluminum. One of the problems I have with brushed metal finishes on peripherals is that they are a great magnet for fingerprints. It gets annoying after a while, because the finish dulls and loses its sheen. Logitech take care of this problem on the G513 by blending aluminum with magnesium, which repels fingerprints. The design is frameless, with floating keycaps that make cleaning up with compressed air a literal and metaphorical breeze. The Logitech G513 is a little disappointing in that there aren't any dedicated media buttons. Instead, you will have to settle for toggleable function keys. It may help to give the keyboard a smaller form factor, but that's not saying much, since there are many other gaming keyboards that have achieved a frameless design while maintaining shortcut keys. The greatest difference between the G513 and the G413 is the introduction of the Roamer G-Linear switch in the G513. This is the first time Logitech has introduced a linear switch in its peripherals. Before, its proprietary switches were only tactile. Logitech promises us that this new linear switch is 25% faster than its competitors, as well as being quieter. I'm not sure about the accuracy of the numbers, but after using this keyboard for a while, I certainly did feel that it was much quieter and faster than the Cherry MX Red switch. S that are only good for gaming and nothing else. This switch was a breath of fresh air. And number 1. ROGCAT Vulcan 120 IMO. Starting at the design, this keyboard looks absolutely beautiful. It has something of a conservative design, especially for a gaming keyboard, but that didn't do anything to take away from its beauty. If anything, it enhanced it. It has an aluminum body with the RGB backlighting that I have come to expect on any serious gaming keyboard. What really makes this keyboard stand out, however, is the design of the keycaps. On most keyboards, the keycaps cover the whole key, switch, and top. The Vulcan 120 IMO is different. Here only top of the keys are covered in keycaps, with the rest of the keys exposed. It certainly makes the keyboard feel beautifully industrial. It also gives the keyboard a very nostalgic retro typewriter feel that anyone would appreciate. Even with that retro feel, don't think for a moment that this typewriter looks too old-fashioned. The RGB lighting takes care of that. It's even more eye-catching with the exposed keys as the lighting glows around the keys and through the transparent keycaps, giving it a very futuristic shine. The electrical bounce time, if ROGCAT's claims are to be believed, is reduced to 4 milliseconds from Cherry MX Switch's 5 milliseconds. That's a 20% reduction in time. While I certainly didn't measure this, I did compare the feel to Cherry MX keyboards and I did think the Vulcan 120 IMO felt a lot more responsive, which made it much better when I was playing fast-paced games or typing frantically. I have included these product link in the description. You can check out this link for more information and latest price. Thank you for watching this video. Please hit the like button. Share with your friends. And be sure to subscribe.